You are lying. Huwag mo akong paglulukuhin, ha? I'll find a way.
Mr. Chair, can I check the record first?
You check it now.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yung folder na binigay niya siya.
Ito. Wala naman. Di ba, no?
Hindi ko alam kung saan mo check in ihon. Niluloko muna kami.
When you entered the facility, you wore a bonnet or covered your face?
That is not true, Mr. Chair. I was not wearing bonnet, Mr.
Okay.
Chair.
Is it true that you turned off the CCTV system inside the jail facility?
That is not true, Mr. Chair.
So none of you did?
Yes, Mr. Chair. With regard to that, Mr. Chair, we had been also charged with that particular violation, Mr. Chair, and by the NBI.
By the NBI?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Also in court?
In court, Mr.
Also
Chair.
Also dismissed?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Oh, you have a very good lawyer.
In relation to the issues raised by the Honorable Flores, Napolcom, na-charge din po ba si Colonel Marcos?
Na-charge, Your Honor, pero hindi ho nag-appeal eh. Suspension lang ata ang sa kanya eh. Kaya hindi na po siya nag-appeal eh. Yung iba lang mga kasama ang nag-appeal.
Was his sentence served?
I suppose so, Your Honor. It's supposed to have been served by this time.
Suspension. How about Major Larraga?
Yes, Mr. Chair. I was demoted, Mr. Chair.
You were demoted?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Samantalang si Colonel Marcos na-promote. Di ba doon sumasama ang loob mo?
No, not necessarily, Mr. Chair.
Not necessarily?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Pero alam ko, sumama ang loob mo eh. Di ba? Dahil ikaw, na-demote siya, na-promote. If you look at the orders of Colonel Marcos, it was through the orders of the President, former President, signed by the Secretary of the Interior and Local Government, as attested by DPRM, if you look at his orders. Di ba? Kaya alam ko, masama yung loob mo dahil hindi ka na ganun eh. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Ako.
Chairman.
Now, Congressman Paduano.
I consulted the COMSEC, and as far as I remember, during the previous hearing, we invite the deponent, no? And now Major Larraga is here. Major, sino nga yung deponent nyo?
Mr. Paul Olendan, Mr. Chair.
Ito,
is he here?
Case to ni Mayor Espinosa.
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
Magkaiba pa yung sa case ni Alvarez.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Now, in the case of Mayor Espinosa, sinong deponent?
Mr. Paul Olendan, Mr. Chair.
Anong background niya? Why was chosen as a deponent?
He was a previous PDL, Mr. Chair.
Previous PDL?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Kaya nga sabi kanina na Polcom na yung comment nung ni Justice, well, in fact, walang direct knowledge yung deponent mo. Kasi dating nakakulong pero nasa labas. Paano siya, kasi supposedly the deponent has direct knowledge, di ba?
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
Why him? Na hindi naman siya nakakulong.
Mr. Chair, based on the
hearsay
testimony of the deponent, Mr. Chair.
Testimony of whom?
Of the deponent, Mr. Chair, which was subjected to...
Ang tanong ko nga sa iyo, kasi ikaw yung nag-apply, di ba, ng search warrant?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Ikaw nag-handle.
Yes,
now, anong testimony niya? Nakita niya na may baril doon sa loob?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Paano niya nakita?
He was, according to him, Mr. Chair, he was able to go inside when he was, if I'm not mistaken, invited, Mr. Chair.
Have you checked the warden that indeed your deponent has visited that jail?
The...
Sandali po, yes or no lang. Ikaw, Major Larraga,
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Huwag ka magsinungaling, yes or no. Have you checked the warden that indeed your deponent has visited the jail to confirm that indeed there's a gun?
Personally, me not. No, Mr. Chair.
Sorry?
Me personally, I did not, Mr. Chair.
Oh, you did not?
Yes, Mr.
But
Chair.
But you applied for a search warrant without checking that indeed yung testimony ng deponent mo na nakapasok siya doon.
I believe, Mr. Chair, I don't have any recourse as to validate.
Ayun yung problema
fact,
mo.
He gets
then why? Then why you apply for search warrant?
Actually, Mr. Chair,
You mentioned about the testimony of your deponent, di ba? Tama?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Now, pinatanong kita, paano mo na-verify na it indeed that this testimony is true and correct?
Mr. Chair, I was made to believe that...
You were made to believe?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
But you have to check. Now, question. Sabi mo kanina, nakita niya, nakapasok siya doon nung nagbisita siya. Tama?
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
Now, doon sa ano po, kay warden. And then the PDL, former PDL that was mentioned by Major Larga, nakabisita po ba siya doon kay Mayor Espinosa?
Mr. Chair, paki...
Major Larga, pakiulit nga po yung pangalan ng former PDL.
Mr. Paul Olindan, Mr. Chair.
Do you know Paul Olindan?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Hindi mo kilala?
Hindi po kilala, Your Honor.
Oh, Major Larga, hindi niya kilala. Former inmate sa Anyon. Siya. Hindi, ikaw, Major. Dapat alam mo yung background ng deponent mo, di ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Saan siya dati nakakulong?
I believe in Aboyog Penal Colony, Mr. Chair.
The same? No.
No, I think...
Mr. Chair. Oh. Mr. Chair.
Yes?
We do not have any PDL by the name of Olindan. And records upon verification of our records, he never visited the Baybay Sub-Provincial Jail Facility.
Oh, Major Larga, hindi siya former detainee o inmate ng provincial jail. Sabi mo nga sa Aboyog. Tapos, hindi rin nag-visit doon. Major Larga, huwag kang magsinungaling.
Mr. Chair, I cannot answer for and in behalf of my deponent and that as to regard of
no,
the
burden. Sadali po. Hindi ko po sinasabi sa iyo that you have to answer. Ikaw po nagsabi na sinabi ng deponent mo na bumisita sa doon.
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
And now, the jail warden confirms na walang nangyaring visit.
I cannot attest to the statement of the jail warden.
Yun nga ang sabi ko sa iyo kanina, tinanong nga kita, have you checked?
Personally, not, Mr. Chair.
Personally?
Me, personally.
Bakit sino ba dapat mag-check?
I believe we have a surveillance personnel who took...
Ikaw ba naman, Major Larga? Ikaw yung nag-apply, principal nag-apply ng mga search warrant, tapos sabihin mo na... Di ba sinabi mo kanina nag-bisita siya?
Based on his testimony, Mr. Chair.
Oh, kaya nga sinasabi ko sa iyo, based on his testimony. Now, kinoconfirm ngayon na walang nangyaring visit yung deponent mo. O, sino ngayon may problema?
Mr. Chair, we have been filed. I was also a respondent or accused of the
sandali po,
criminal case.
I am not asking you about your case. Well, in fact, demotion nga lang eh, di ba? You were just demoted.
The criminal case for malicious application of search
warrant. And now you're invoking sub-judice in
no,
this
no,
committee?
No, Mr. Chair, that was also the... there was a case filed against me, Mr. Chair, and then
so
the search warrant. Actually, Mr. Chair, it was the Honorable Judge through searching questions and answers who made the probable cause and issued the same, which until now, Mr. Chair, was as ruled by the Supreme Court, was valid and the application was proper. I believe, Mr. Chair. I submit to the Supreme Court's ruling, Mr. Chair. If
valid.
That's my humble submission, Mr. Chair.
Na valid yung application ng search warrant?
Yes, Mr. Chair. It was in the ruling of the Supreme Court, Mr. Chair. I humbly submit.
May I know?
Sandali.
May I know? Anong ruling yan?
Mr. Chair, it was a consolidated case. Of all of the confused...
Are you a lawyer? Are you a lawyer?
I'm not, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Can you give me a... Do you have a copy with you of the ruling?
Yes, Mr. Chair, I have.
Pingin nga kami. Paige, can you please get a copy and submit this copy to the chair? Please proceed, Congressman Paduano.
Sino po yung nag-file ng case against...
It was the NBI, Mr. Chair.
The NBI?
Yeah, perjury and malicious application of search warrant, Mr. Chair.
So, the Supreme Court decided in favor?
No, sir, at the Municipal Trial Court of Basay Samar, Mr. Chair.
So, nag-appeal ba yung NBI? Did they appeal?
I think they did not, Mr. Chair.
They didn't?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Oh, ito yung problema. NBI, are you familiar with the case?
Good evening, Mr. Chair. We are familiar with the case. However, with the if the questions will be about the case itself, we would like to have a moment with the records and we will submit the records of the case on the next hearing, Your Honor.
Update kami dito, no? Kasi while you're telling this committee na yung MTC rules favorable to your case, tama?
That is correct, Mr. Chair. It was dismissed, Mr. Chair.
Pero alam mo na rin ngayon na there is a Supreme Court ruling also.
It was issued last...
Sandali, na bawal mag-issue ng search warrant on government facilities.
Actually, Mr. Chair, it was fully discussed in the ruling, Mr. Chair, that it is allowed to apply a search warrant for a criminal investigation.
Sa MTC yan?
No, Mr. Chair, from the Supreme Court in bank, Mr. Chair. The one that I give the ruling, Mr. Chair, it was fully discussed in there, Mr. Chair. That's why I said I humbly submit to the ruling of the Supreme Court with that regard, Mr. Chair.
Hindi, papacheck namin ha. Papacheck namin kasi magkaiba tayo ng appreciation dyan sa ruling ng Supreme Court. Yes?
Mr. Chair, I think Major Gargar, the question of Chairman Paduano was whether or not you knew for a fact that there was no, that the deponent that you brought before the court was not a detainee. Did you have prior knowledge of the fact that he was not a detainee?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So alam mong hindi siya detainee?
At that moment, Mr. Chair, he was already outside. Yeah, previously, Mr. Chair.
But you just heard the warden say that they have no records of him being a detainee.
It was from a different facility, Mr. Chair.
But you just said that it was the Abayog... what was that?
Abuyog. Abuyog.
Abuyog?
Yes, that is correct, Mr. Chair. They are from the Baybay jail.
Baybay sub-provincial facility kami.
Okay, so where was Mayor Espinosa detained?
Baybay sub-provincial jail facility.
Baybay. And you were at, what was your place? Abuyog? Well, are you at Baybay?
Baybay.
Kayo?
Yes, sir.
And he was, Major Gargar was saying that the deponent that they brought was also a detainee at Baybay? Tama
no,
ba?
he was detained at a different place. So if, yes, he was, if he was detained at a different place, how could he say, or how could he testify that Mayor Espinosa had these illegal things in his cell?
Mr. Chair, if I may be able to,
if they were detained at different institutions.
Mr. Chair, if I may be able to discuss.
Go ahead, sir. Please.
Mr. Chair, the situation kasi noon, Mr. Chair, is that PDLs or those previously detained and also inside the jail, Mr. Chair, they have all connections from different,
so
different
jails.
So sinasabi
mo, chismis lang, Marites. He heard. He didn't actually see.
No, Mr. Chair, he was able to penetrate. Based on his testimony, Mr. Chair, that is not my testimony, Mr.
He is detained at a different facility, yet before, he was able to penetrate?
Before, Mr. Chair, before. So he has knowledge, he knows the yung kalakaran po sa loob ng mga jails, yung with regard to illegal drug trade, Mr. Chair.
Knowing the kalakaran and actually seeing it and having personal knowledge of these things are two different things. Major Laraga, tama po ba?
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
Oh, so you bring an opponent who had no personal knowledge of the things except just knowing the kalakaran in the area? Yan ang deponent mo? For the issuance of a search warrant?
No, Mr. Chair. He has personal knowledge, Mr. Chair.
How did he get personal knowledge again? Can you enlighten me po?
In his testimony, Mr. Chair, he was able to penetrate.
How did he penetrate a jail facility without him being detained there? Was he a jail guard?
There was his, actually, I don't have his sworn affidavit.
Well, you
Mr.
interviewed
Chair,
him, I'm sure, di ba? Major Laraga, in-interview mo siya before mo siya pinresenta sa korte, tama?
Yes, Mr. Chair, and he was subjected to a searching question and answer
by
the issuing judge.
No, I'm asking you, in-interview mo ba yung deponent mo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Oh, so ano
by
niya?
The investigator also.
Yes, paano niya nalaman? How did he have personal knowledge? Yan ang gusto mo malaman.
It was in his affidavit,
I'm
Mr.
asking
Chair.
You. You interviewed him. You just said that you interviewed him.
Yun nga, Mr. Chair, nakapasok siya doon.
Paano nga makapasok?
Nagka-transaction sila ni, if I'm not mistaken, doon sa ano. Nagkaroon sila ng mismong physical ano ni the late mayor.
Okay,
Espinosa.
Major Laraga, explain how he explained to you paano siya nakapasok as an ordinary civilian na hindi detainee in a jail facility. Paano siya nakapasok?
Actually, Mr. Chair, the allegation na mayroong collusion between mga bantay doon sa loob is yun yung reason na nakapasok sila. And that has been already almost public knowledge in the penal institutions there in Region 8, Mr. Chair. Alam naman po nung almost lahat ng operatiba doon prior to that, Mr. Chair. Talagang
so ang sinabi niya sa'yo na, by collusion with some jail guards maybe and some other persons inside the jail, he was able to go inside. Is that correct?
Yes,
Laraga?
Mr. Chair. Through the influence of the drug lord, Espinosa drug group.
And that from his entry into that facility, he was able to see firsthand how things were being done. That's why you're saying that he had personal knowledge of these things.
That
correct?
Is correct, Mr. Chair, based on his testimony, Mr.
And
Chair.
You believe that, Major Laraga?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Because you brought
I
him.
Because prior to that, Mr. Chair, I had been operative and we already had an intel information. Okay. With regard to that illegal drug trade inside a penal colony and in a detention facilities,
okay.
Mr. Chair.
Okay, now, is that the reason why when you entered the facility, you wore a bonnet or covered your face?
Mr. Chair, that is not true, Mr.
That
Chair.
Is not
I was
true.
Not I was not wearing bonnet, Mr.
Okay.
Chair.
Is it true that you turned off the CCTV system inside the jail facility?
That is not true, Mr. Chair.
So none of you did. It was all working at the same time.
Yes, Mr. Chair. With regard to that, Mr. Chair, we had been also charged with that particular violation, Mr. Chair,
and
by the NBI.
By the NBI?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Also in court?
In court, Mr.
Also
Chair.
Dismissed?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Oh, you have a very good lawyer. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Flores.
Mr.
Yes,
Chair.
Congressman Acop.
Yes. Major Laraga, how long have you been with CIDG?
Since 8 years. Almost 8 years, Mr. Chair.
8 years?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And how many times have you applied for a search warrant?
Several times already, Mr. Chair.
Several times?
That is correct, Mr. Chair.
Now, may I know kung yung deponent ninyo dun sa kaso ni Mayor Espinosa ay walk-in o kayo ang nag-secure?
I believe there was a...
Why, ano ang talagang nangyari? Hindi ko tinatanong kung ano yung paniwala mo.
Pardon, I'm sorry,
ang
Mr. Chair.
Ang tinatanong ko, whether your deponent ay walk-in, nag-volunteer na sarili niya, o hinanap ninyo. Hindi ko tinatanong kung anong paniwala mo.
Yes, sir. Thank you. It was si... Not walk-in, Mr. Chair. It was
ano
not
nga?
Walk-in.
Nag-volunteer siya?
No, Mr. Chair.
Hinanap niyo siya?
Our age, police,
there was
a police handler. There was a police handler, Mr. Chair.
Ano?
There was a handler, Mr. Chair, an agent.
Sino yung handler na police na yun?
He was already retired, Mr. Chair.
Galing mong gumawa ng istorya eh.
Yes, I'm certain,
now,
Mr. Chair.
Sige, assuming na mayroon siyang handler, since when na naging handler yung kuan na yun, informat nyo na yun, yung deponent? Binubola mo na ako eh.
Hindi, actually, hindi naman po Mr. Chair na bubola, Mr. Chair. Talagang mayroon lang po talaga siyang personal knowledge sa
hindi ko naman
pangyayari.
Tinatanong ko may personal knowledge eh. Ang tinatanong ko, how did you come to know the deponent? Ikaw nag-apply ng search warrant eh.
It was introduced to me by our personnel, Mr. Chair. That na mayroong...
Sino nga yung nag-introduce sa'yo? What's the name?
Of our personnel, Mr. Chair.
Oo nga. Marunong ka bang umintindi ng English? Tatagalugin ko. Sino ang nag-introduce sa'yo nung deponent?
It was retired Kayubit, Mr. Chair.
Alin? Retired na siya nung in-introduce niya?
No, right
active
now.
Active pa siya noon?
Active pa siya noon at that
May
time.
May know the name and the address?
Melvin Kayubit, Mr. Chair, at Palo Olete.
Ano?
Melvin Kayubit.
Melvin Kayubit.
May, Mr. Chair, may move that we, in the next hearing, we invite subject person mentioned by Mayor Laraga as the deponent in the search warrant against or issued against the late Mayor Espinosa?
Comsec, you are directed to invite the said person named by Congressman Acop.
Nung ipinakilala sa iyo yung deponent, ano ang protocol dapat kung si IDG ka for 8 years?
Yes, Mr. Chair, I have to... Of course, the investigator must interview and do a background and validation, Mr. Chair.
You have to conduct a review, interview and validation
of the background. The investigator, Mr. Chair, our investigator who will get the
and
testimony.
Who was the investigator who conducted the review, the interview and validation?
It was, Mr. Chair, can I check the record first?
You check it now.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yung folder na binigay niya siya.
Ito. Wala naman, di ba no?
Hindi ko alam kung saan mo check-in iyon. Niluloko mo na kami.
I'm sorry, Mr. Chair. Baka magkamali ako dun sa pangalan, Mr.
Sige
Chair.
Sige nga, hanapin mo. Saan mo hanapin dyan?
Mr. Chair, I could not, if my recollection is correct, Mr. Chair, it was PO3 Johnny Ibanez.
PO3 Johnny
Ibanez, Mr. Chair.
Is he still in the active service?
I believe he already also retired, Mr. Chair.
He also retired?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
PO3 siya, nag-retire?
Yes, Mr. Chair, PO3.
PO3. Nag-retire siya, mandatory or optional?
I think
kasi
it's optional.
Siya, kailan lang nangyari yun, optional. So wala pa siyang 20 years or 30 years or 56 years old.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Maybe optional, Mr. Chair.
Optional. Huwag mo akong paglulukuhin, ha? I'll find a way. Colonel Punanan, will you please take the name dun sa sinabi niya and kindly give this committee the details whether nag-retire nga siya optionally o hindi? Pakitanong sa kanya yung pangalan at rank ko. Kasi the way you're answering me, you're already quibbling, Major Laraga. Now, noong in-interview at saka vinalidate, ikaw ba nag-conduct ng sarili mong validation when the investigator reported to you as far as his validation is concerned?
Negative, Mr. Chair.
Negative. Wala ka nang ginawa. Hindi ka man lang nagtaka.
Informally, Mr. Chair.
I beg your pardon?
Informally, just calling some, you know.
Hindi mo tinignan kung anong resulta ng validation?
Tinignan naman po, Mr. Chair.
And you did not find it unreasonable na isang dating PDL nagsasabi ng may baril yung isang PDL sa ibang detention center?
Eh, credible naman po yung binabanggit ng
credible sa iyo?
Yes, please, Mr. Chair.
Ang galing mong sumagot, pero yung bagay na yon is credible sa iyo?
Oo naman, Mr. Chair.
Paano maging credible yun? Paano niya nalaman na merong baril si Mayor Espinosa doon sa Juan?
Mayroon po siyang personal knowledge doon, Mr. Chair.
Ano nga? You define personal knowledge to me.
Personally po, nagkaharap po sila ni...
Paano sila nagkaharap?
I cannot discuss the details. It should be
Why
the deponent, Mr. Chair.
Why can't you not discuss? Ikaw ang nag-apply eh.
I based Mr. only... Chair? I endorsed the... In the application, Mr. Chair, I endorsed the...
Hindi
the
nga,
testimony of
nga
the Sunati David.
Nung nag-report sa iyo, hindi mo ba napansin kung reasonable o unreasonable yung validation? Kasi dapat magsuspecha ka na paano nakapagbibigay yung isang tao na dating PDL pero hindi naman PDL sa baybay ng statement na may baril si the late Mayor Espinosa doon sa selda niya.
Mr. Chair, kasi nakapasok daw siya doon, sir. At saka may contact, may connection naman sila.
Major Laraga, kasasabi lang ng mga officials doon, ni wala silang bisita na ganun, ni hindi sila nagkaroon ng PDL na ganun. You are lying!
I'm sorry, Mr. Chair, but I cannot...
Mr. Chair, may respectfully move that we cite Major Laraga in contempt
Seconded.
For violation of Section 11.
Seconded.
There's a motion.
So move, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion to cite Major Laraga in contempt for violating Section 11.
Seconded.
And duly seconded. Are there any objections? Hearing none, you are now cited in contempt, Major Laraga. Comsec, take note.
Second motion, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Congressman Paduana.
May I respectfully move that Major Laraga will be detained in the Quezon City Jail in a period of until the committee report will be approved in the plenary, Mr. Chairman. So move.
There is a motion to detain Major Laraga at the Quezon City Jail until the termination of the committee hearing and it in the approval of the committee report in the plenary. Any second? Julie seconded. Any objections? Hearing none. The motion is approved.